Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a failing starter. The starter is an electric motor responsible for generating the torque to actually get the engine started. So essentially the starter connects to the flywheel, which delivers a brief and significant amount of torque to actually rotate the crankshaft and get the engine started so it can begin running under its own power. When it comes to signs and symptoms of a failing starter motor, some of them can be very similar to that of a battery or an alternator failure. Now, we do have videos on both battery and alternator failures. So if you're trying to diagnose the issue and you're unsure whether you have an issue with the starter, battery, or alternator, be sure to check out those videos as well. And as we move throughout this video, I'll try to give a couple pointers on ways to distinguish where and when you can tell if it's an issue with the starter, the alternator, or the battery. And I'll mostly circle back to that towards the end of this video. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common symptoms of a failing starter. Number one, we have a no crank, no start, or weak crank symptom. Typically, when the starter fails, you'll actually end up with a no crank, no start. That'll be the most common symptom if the starter completely gives out. However, there are times where the starter may just be failing slowly. So when the starter begins giving out, you may just get a weak crank, and the engine might actually end up firing up if the starter is able to generate just enough torque to get the engine fired up. It's possible that you can actually get the engine up and running, but ultimately the no crank and no start is going to be the most common. And then again, occasionally you might end up with that weak crank. And in that situation, the engine may start or it may not start depending on the degree of starter failure and whether or not it's able to generate just enough torque to get the engine to crank over and run under its own power. Symptom number two of starter failure, we have clicking or other sounds. Now, the biggest thing here is going to be the clicking. When you turn the key or press the start button, basically when you fire up the ignition, if you start to hear a series of rapid continued clicking, that is typically a dead giveaway that you do have an issue with the starter motor. So ultimately what that means is the reason you hear the clicking sound is there's a solenoid, which is usually attached directly to the starter itself. And that solenoid is what actually makes the clicking sound. So ultimately when you hear that rapid continued clicking, that means the solenoid is doing its job and trying to actually engage the starter motor, but the starter itself is not working. Now there are some other sounds that you may hear with a failing starter. You may just get one click. It's possible that you don't hear the continued rapid clicking. You might not even hear any sounds at all. And that's especially common if it's an issue with the actual starter solenoid itself. Again, that's what creates or causes the clicking sound. So if you don't hear any clicking, it's possible that it's an issue with the solenoid itself rather than the starter. But ultimately, all tied into the same thing. And a couple other weird sounds that you may hear could be whirring or grinding noises. However, those sounds are a little bit less common with starter failure and can also be something attributed with issues with the alternator. Moving on to sign and symptom number three of a failing starter motor, we have no electrical problems. So this is a symptom instead of being something where an actual issue is present. There are no issues with the electrical system. So ultimately you turn the key in the ignition, push the start button. Whatever you do to engage the ignition, all of the dashboard lights light up, your headlights are working, the radio's working fine, windows are working fine. Essentially all electronic components within the vehicle are working as intended and as usual. This can be a sign of starter failure because that does indicate that the battery has enough power to actually run all of the electronics and accessories. And so that leads back to ultimately a starter failure. Now it is possible that it could still be a battery failure. A battery or an alternator might have just enough power to power up those basic accessories, but not enough to actually start the vehicle. But in those situations, you'll typically notice that the car will actually at least try to start cranking. And then after it starts cranking, maybe the engine doesn't fire up. And then afterwards, the electronics start not working because at that point, when it tried to engage a starter motor, that draws a lot of amps, a lot of voltage from the battery, so that'll quickly drain the battery. And at that point, you might start noticing issues with the electrical systems, the radio, windows, headlights, dash lights, etc. But ultimately, if you are able to run those electronic accessories for an extended period, especially after a few minutes, and you're just getting no crank, no start whatsoever, that typically indicates an issue with the starter rather than with the battery or the alternator. Moving on to symptom number four of a failing starter motor, we have smoke or electrical burning smells. Again, as I briefly mentioned before, When you do engage the ignition and try to turn the vehicle on, the starter draws a significant amount of power and voltage from the battery. And so if you do have an issue with the starter, it's possible that can then begin overheating the electrical system, especially if you try starting the vehicle multiple times. And it continues sending this large amount of power and voltage to the starter. You can start overheating the electrical system, and that's when you can start to see issues like smoke coming from the engine bay or an electrical burning smell. So if you do notice, this is definitely something that's a very serious sign and symptom. So if you are running into that issue, definitely don't try starting the vehicle anymore. Try to get that problem diagnosed and fixed as soon as possible to avoid doing further damage to the electrical system, which of course can end up being very complicated and complex repairs depending on what overheats or what damage is done there. One final note on the smoke and burning electrical smells. This is certainly not a very common sign or symptom, just something worth mentioning because of the potential severity if you do overheat the electrical system, and again, it caused much more expensive and severe damage. Moving on to symptom number 5, last but not least, another possible symptom of starter failure are visual cues. So if you look in the area of the starter motor and you notice that it is coated in oil or any sort of other fluid, that could point out that maybe you had an oil leak or a coolant leak or any kind of fluid leak that was dripping onto the starter motor. Now, in most vehicles, a starter is in a location where it is prone to dripping from a lot of these leaks, whether it be oil leaks or coolant leaks. The starter is usually in an area prone to dripping from those other leaks, and of course, having any fluids dripping onto electrical components like the starter or the starter solenoid isn't good, and over time it can begin wearing down that starter and causing failure. So if you do a quick visual inspection, notice that something looks off, the starter is caked in oil or other kind of fluid, or it just looks wet, or anything really looks off or damaged with the starter, then that could be a sign that you do have an issue with the starter motor that was ultimately caused by another issue from the engine, like leaking engine oil or coolant. That wraps up the 5 most common signs and symptoms of a starter failure. Now again, we've mentioned a few times throughout the video that a starter, battery, and alternator can all show fairly similar signs and symptoms of failure, especially things like with the engine not starting, not cranking, and not turning over. So one way to really test that and get a better idea of what issue you actually have at hand is doing a simple jump start test. So if you try jump starting the vehicle and the engine still does not crank, still won't start, not even trying to crank, then the starter is your likely issue, because ultimately it doesn't matter how much power you can get from the battery or how charged up the battery is. If the starter isn't working, it won't be able to actually start spinning the flywheel and crankshaft, and the engine won't start. If you jump start the vehicle and the engine fires up and then dies shortly after, that could be a sign of an alternator problem. And the reason for that is the alternator is actually what supplies electrical current and power to most accessories once the engine is actually up and running. So ultimately, if you're able to jumpstart the vehicle and then it dies, that's a sign of alternator failure, because the engine's running, the alternator takes over powering all of the equipment, especially the ignition process, to actually send the voltage to the ignition coils and spark plugs. And so if the alternator can't keep up with those demands, that will ultimately lead to the car dying and stalling out. And then last but not least, if you are able to jump start the car and it continues running, everything's just fine with the vehicle after a jump start, then that likely points to a battery problem. And that's especially true if you jump start it. Car runs fine, everything's great. It sits in the garage overnight or sits outside overnight. You go out the next morning, try to fire the engine up, and suddenly it's not starting again. That's likely a bad battery, and the battery is just draining rapidly, but a jump start will get you up and running just fine, and everything is good until the battery depletes and loses its charge again. So really, that jump start test is going to be one of the simplest and most effective ways to help point you in the right direction as to whether you have an issue with the starter, alternator, or battery. That said, that wraps up our video for today, guys. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.